Let's say I have a washer machine and I'm looking for the owner's manual for that washer machine. I may start out just by going to google.com and typing in Maytag washer manual. And I'll just hit enter to search. Okay, now my search term was pretty general, and I will say that anytime you're searching Google to get better results, the more specific you can be, the better. And as you can see, we have some pretty broad results. So how can we narrow this down? Well, first of all, if we're only looking for results that are recent, we can go up to the search bar and we can simply add the year. So I could add 2019. And this is a quick way to narrow down to more recent search results. If, however, we're still seeing old results for whatever we're looking for, we could actually go over here to the Tools section of Google Search. And this is available on mobile devices as well, although you might have to scroll over a little bit with your finger to get to the Tools section. And when you click on Tools, you'll notice that there's a drop-down that says Anytime. And this allows us to specify that we want results that are specifically from the last hour, 24 hours, last week, and so forth. I use this feature every single day. This is great for software tutorials because they get out of date so quickly. It's also great for news articles. If you've been following a topic for maybe the past year or a couple years, but you want to find out the absolute most recent information on that topic, you can search Google and you can come in here and say, I want to see news from the past 24 hours, and it will only show you those results. So for now, we'll just leave this at any time, but definitely make use of the time dropdown. Super useful feature here in Google Search. Now, I mentioned earlier, it's always important to be specific when you're searching Google. So one thing we could do is we could take the year out of the top here, and we could instead enter the model number of this washer machine. So I could start typing it, and you'll notice that when I start typing, we get a drop-down list of suggested searches. These are searches that a lot of people have been searching. So if I don't really know the model number of my washer or I forget what it is, I could start typing it in the first few letters, and then I could see the drop-down list, and maybe I'd be able to determine from that list the actual model number of my washer. So definitely keep an eye on those automatic results as you're searching, because they might help you find what you're looking for. Here's the model number of my washer, so I'm just going to click to see the results for that. If we scroll down a little bit here, we'll see that our results are starting to get a little more specific. We actually have the model number in some of these results. To be even more specific, however, we could go back up to our search term and we could put the model number in quotations. This means that we only want to see results that have this exact search term. This could also be a phrase, so we could have multiple words inside the quotes. This is very useful when searching song lyrics or book and movie quotes. At the same time, maybe I'm looking for the official PDF owner's manual for this washer. So I only want to see results from Maytag.com. So I could go up here to the search box and I could type in site colon Maytag.com. And then I could hit enter to research this. Now you'll notice if I look at my results, I'm only seeing results from Maytag.com. Great, we've gotten even more specific. Additionally, I know that I want the PDF version of this owner's manual, so I could go back up into the search box, and this time I could type file type, colon, PDF, and I don't need the dot, just PDF, and then hit enter. So now you can see that we've gotten a little too specific. So let's go ahead and take the quotes off our model number here and search that again. Okay, so now I'm seeing results that are only from Maytag.com. They're only PDFs, so you can see the result right here is a PDF, and hey, look, I got one result. So we have really narrowed our search down. We're searching for the Maytag washer manual, we enter the model number, we enter the website that we want to see results from, we enter the type of file, and we got it down to one result. That's awesome. We searched Google for something, and I bet you that this is what we're looking for. Let's click to open it. Boom. We've got our Maytag owner's manual in PDF version. This is exactly what we were looking for. So you can see that when you're searching Google, you can kind of go into this flow and continue to narrow down and narrow down. Now, there are a few other things that I want to talk about here in Google Search. So let's just delete out most of our search query and we'll just search for Maytag washer. What I want to talk about now is I want to talk about these categories up here across the top of Google Search. So if we were looking to purchase a Maytag washer, we could click on the shopping category, and I actually use this quite a bit. I don't use this for shopping on, say, like Amazon or online websites, but what I'll do is if I want to purchase something today, I'll go in here to Google and I'll search for it and I'll go to the shopping category and then I'll go over here to the left and click on available nearby. So now I can see, hey, I want to buy a washing machine today. Well, I can go to Lowe's and I can purchase one. So this is great for finding products that are available in the geographic location that you're located in. You can also use a lot of these other options up here for searching Google as well. If you want to see specifically videos, definitely use the video feature. It's going to search heavily YouTube, but it will also search videos that are elsewhere on the internet. You can search specifically for news using the news category, and then you see you have books, flights, and finance as some other categories. But I want to talk about images actually a little in depth. So let's click on the images category. We're still searching for Maytag washer, but when we search images here in Google and we actually go to the images category, we can click on this tools section and you'll notice that we have some additional options. We can actually choose the size of images that we'd like to see. So sometimes when I'm searching for images to use on my website, I only want to see high resolution images. So I'll choose large and it will only show me the large images. We can also choose specific colors that we'd like to see, whether the images have rights for us to reuse them. So that's nice if you're looking for something that you're going to be putting on a website, something like that. Images that are only from a specific time. So that's what we looked at earlier. So when you're searching images here in Google, definitely don't forget that you can really narrow down your results with some of these options up here at the top of Google search. I think it's also important to note that we can do a reverse image search here in Google by coming in here to the images section of Google search, and then we can click on the camera icon. You'll notice it says search by image. So we could paste the URL of an image right in here and it will search for it. Or we could click to upload an image from our computer to Google and it will search. So this is a great way to find out the original source of a particular image that you may have found elsewhere. Okay, so there you have my suggestions on how to search Google as effectively as possible. Don't forget to check out the Ahrefs article. It has all of the advanced operators that you can use in Google search. So anything that I forgot to show you during this video, you should be able to find in this article. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.